Good morning, student. How are you? Hope you are safe and sound. Dear student, in my previous lecture, I discussed regarding the whole syllabus of English code number 65712. Lecture 2, this is regarding uses of tenses. Uses of tenses. You know, tense is called the mother of English. You know, tense is called the mother of English. Without knowledge of tense, you can't write even a sentence correctly. So you must have a sound clear knowledge about the function of tense, about the uses of tense. What is tense? Tense is relating to time. Tense is relating to time. The time of verb. The time of verb is called tense. Tense mainly three kinds. Present tense. Number two. Past tense. Number three, future tense. The action which is happened present, this is called present tense. The action which is occurred in past, this is called past time. And the action which will happen in future, this is called future. Tense mainly three kinds. Present tense, past tense and future tense. Each of tense can be classified into four. Each of tense can be classified into four. Number one, indefinite. Number two, continuous. Number three, perfect. And number four, perfect continuous. So if you add before indefinite, it is present, this is present indefinite, present continuous, present perfect, and present perfect continuous. If you add past, this is past indefinite, past continuous, past perfect, and past perfect continuous. If you add before future, this is future indefinite, future continuous, future perfect, and future perfect continuous. So total number of tense is 12. Actually, you have to remind the taxa of the tense, not definition of the tense. So in brief, you have to remind the taxa of the tense, how you use in sentence. So you have to remind the taxa of the tense. Firstly, you have to remind the auxiliary verb relating to tense. I am writing here, yeah, number one, present indefinite. Do, does. Number two, present continuous. Am, is, are. Number three, present perfect. Have, has. Number four, present perfect continuous. Have been, has been. Number five, past indefinite. Did. Number six, past continuous. Was, were. Number seven, past perfect. Had. Number eight, past perfect continuous. Had been. Nine, future indefinite. Shall, will. Number 10, future continuous. Shall be, will be. Number 11, future perfect. Shall have, will have. Number 12, future perfect continuous. Shall have been, will have been. These are the auxiliary verbs relating to respective tense. You have to remind the auxiliary verb. Of course, you have to remind this in order to do the function of tense correctly. This is present indefinite, do did, do does, present continuous, am, is, are, present perfect, have, has, present perfect continuous, have been, past indefinite, did, past continuous, was, were, past perfect, had, past perfect continuous, have been, future indefinite, shall, will, future continuous, shall be, will be, future perfect, shall have, will have, future perfect continuous, shall have been, will have been. This is the auxiliary verb. This is a, of course, a key point. You must remind this auxiliary verb, because without auxiliary verb, you can't identify what tense easily. So, you must remind the auxiliary verb clearly. Subject verb. object. Subject is verb verb. Subject is verb. Object. Number 3. Subject four classes of present. Present tense. This is the four classes of present. Present tense. That is present indefinite. That means subject, verb, object. Subject, verb, object. Present continuous. Subject. ASB. ASB means helping. Helping verb. ASB means helping verb. ASB helping verb. If you use here, if you use here am, is, are. This is present continuous. This is present continuous. If you use here was, were, this is past continuous. This is continuous means V1 ING. Where there is continuous, must have V1 ING. V1 ING. Only you use that is auxiliary verb that I previously discussed. If you use just here the auxiliary verb, then it is continuous. What continuous? If you were am is are, this is present continuous. If you use here was were, this is past continuous. If you use here shall be, will be. This is future continuous. This is future continuous. If you use here, have been, has been. If you use here, have been, this is here, present perfect continuous. This is perfect, present perfect continuous. If you use here have been, this is perfect continuous. Present past perfect continuous. If you use here shall have been, will have been. This is future perfect continuous. Only what you remind, this is the auxiliary verb. Continuous means verb ing. Subject, object, this is common items. You must only use auxiliary verb. So if you use here am is are, this is present continuous. If you use was or this is past continuous. Shall be, will be, this is future continuous. Have been, has been, this is present perfect continuous, have been, this is past perfect continuous, and shall have been, will have been, this is future perfect continuous. So, this is the transfer of the continuous. Subject V1 object. This is present indefinite. Subject object, subject V1 object. This is present indefinite. If you subject V2 object, this is past indefinite. This is past indefinite. V1 means first form of verb, root form of verb or base form of verb. V2 means past form of verb. Okay. Subject shall will plus V1 plus object. This is the transfer of future indefinite. Subject V1 object. This is present indefinite. Subject V2 object. This is past indefinite. Subject shall will V1 object. This is future indefinite. Perfect. Subject have plus with it. This is the transfer of perfect. Subject have with it. If you found such transfer, this is perfect. This is perfect. What perfect? You have to identify on the basis of auxiliary verb. On the basis of auxiliary verb. Subject has plus with it. This is present perfect. This is present perfect. Subject have V3 past perfect. Past perfect. Subject shall have, will have plus V3. Subject shall have, will have V3. This is future perfect. So perfect, how you, what perfect you identify, this is on the basis of perfect. Perfect, what is the basic transfer of perfect? That is subject have, has, had. You must have, has, had and V3. So this is, if you find subject have, has, V3, this is present perfect. If you, subject have V3, this is past perfect. Subject shall have, will have V3, this is perfect, future perfect. So this is the basic structure of, basic structure of the tense. Thank you. subject verb object, subject verb object, you must, this is called syntax. If you want to write a sentence, you must follow this structure, that is subject verb object. Subject verb object, this is assertive. ASV, that is helping verb, subject verb object, this is interrogative. Number three, subject helping verb, not verb object, this is negative. Number four, helping verb, not subject verb object, this is negative interrogative. Negative interrogative. If you write a reference, I, he reads a book. If you identify this is he subject verb, this is verb an object. Any type of verb, V1, V2, V3 or I, any type, this is subject verb object, this is called assertive. This is called assertive. What tense it is? It is subject verb object, this is the present intimate tense. I formally discussed, this is the what tense. You must remind the structure and auxiliary verb. Previously I discussed. Okay, subject verb object, this is the structure of present intimate tense. If you transform this sentence into interrogative, if you transform this sentence into interrogative, you write some firstly auxiliary verb. What auxiliary verb? Present intimate tense, do or does. Where does, where do. Where subject third person singular number, that is he, she, it or any name or any single item. This is present, this is third person singular number. They are does. So you must firstly write helping verb, this is does. Then subject, subject means he. Then verb, this is read. And then object, a book. Then of the note of interrogation. If you transform this sentence into negative, then you firstly write subject. Subject means he. And then auxiliary verb, does. And then not read a book. If you transform this sentence into negative interrogative, then first you use helping verb, that is does. Then not, then subject, then verb, and then note of intonation. So this sentence is present intimate tense. Any tense, any sentence, you can transform these four sentences. So this is the reference of present intimate tense. And sentence is assertive. Sentence is assertive. And the next is interrogative and negative, and negative interrogative. You can change any sentence into such four types. So how you identify, how you identify shortly, if you find saw, if you find saw towards the end of the verb in Bengali, present, past, in Bengali, that is the towards the end of the verb, that means kiya, kiya, shesha, saw. If you find saw, this is related to present. If you law, this is past, and ba, this is future. This is future. indefinite, continuous, perfect, perfect, continuous. In Sanskrit, in brief, towards the end of the verb, that's kya shishe? Te. Te thakle continuous, untestant, agatle perfect, shomoy plus te. This is perfect continuous and shunno, this is past indefinite. If there is no such type, this is indefinite. Share pore share or change. সে পরি আসে সে দুই ঘন্টা যাবৎ পরিতে সে or a there is no noun, so it is he reads. Pori te se. Sorry. Te se. Te. This is called. If you find sa, this is present. And ta, this is continuous. Ta, this is continuous. So, what is the taxon of continuous? That is, subject M is a V1 ing. He is reading. Ah, which is fine. So, this is perfect. And so, this is present. So, this is called present perfect. What is the taxon of present perfect? Subject M has V3 object. So if he has read. So shomoy, this is 2 ghonta. Shomoy, that is te. This is perfect continuous. Shomoy te. 2 ghonta, this is shomoy and te. This is called present perfect continuous. So what is the structure? That is subject. Have been, has been. Here third person singular number. That is why has been. And V1 ing has been reading. You similarly complete all the tense following this structure. If you find saw, this is present. Law, this is past. Was, this is future. And indefinite, continuous, perfect continuous. If you hear use was, this is then Bengali here she porite silo. Porite silo. So similarly you can remind all the tenses in a brief way. So dear students, you exercise this at home, and my next class I will discuss about voice. Thank you very much. God Allah bless you.